Good morning. Thanks for joining us for Friday's session. The local share market's going to get off to a pretty good start this morning as well. The futures are telling us that the ASX 200 will be up by just a whisker under 1%. 0.95% was the gain that we saw for SPY futures in after hours trade. And that is a reflection of what was a constructive session as far as Northern Hemisphere trade was concerned more broadly. But in terms of what we saw on Wall Street last night, it was quite encouraging to see a new record being posted by the S&P 500 with a gain of 0.7%, the NASDAQ up by 0.33%, and the Dow Jones up by around 0.9%. So the important point to note here is, of course, earlier in the week, we had quite a substantial sell-off for all three of those indices. That response to the hotter than expected CPI numbers. You had indices hurtling lower in the order of around 1.5%, but in the days following, they've been able to consolidate and they have indeed returned to those levels, pre-sell-off essentially. So that means that the sentiment in the market is taking into consideration the earnings, the economic backdrop, and indeed the outlook for interest rates, and for the moment seem to be quite pleased with it. So there were some quite a number of economic releases last night, so I won't bore you with all of them. One of the ones that stood out, however, were the retail sales numbers for the month of January. So worth pointing out that the Christmas retail season generally has been recalibrated these days because of those massive online shopping events that predate Christmas. You know, the Cyber Monday, the Black Friday sales, all that sort of thing has really reorganized the way that consumers approach the Christmas shopping period. So worth keeping that in mind. The numbers for retail sales in the US in January, down 0.8%. Market was looking for a flat outcome in that respect. It was the biggest fall since March of last year. So that was one of the factors that contributed to a decline where US interest rates are concerned. So we saw a fall where 2- and 10-year government bonds were concerned last night in the United States, and at the margins that was a reassurance as far as the stock side of things are concerned. However, if you want to unseat that argument, you can talk about the stronger than expected outcomes in relation to the number of people claiming unemployment benefits. That was the lowest in about a month. And there were a couple of manufacturing surveys out last night. One of the ones that stood out to me was the Philadelphia Federal Reserve's measure of activity. So that's an important one in terms of the northeast of the US. It was the first positive reading since August. It was a pretty big jump, up by about 16 points. And the underlying measures with this were quite constructive in terms of pointing to further improvement where manufacturing is concerned. So we'll press on to what was going on as far as the corporate landscape was concerned. So Alphabet, the parent of Google, they've got a autonomous driving business as well called Waymo, and they've had an instance where yet another car has had a collision and they've had to revise the software, and that was a factor that was just weighing on sentiment around Alphabet shares, which finished lower overnight. Rivian was the opposite. So this is the electric car maker that's really been savaged in the early weeks of this year. It's fallen by as much as 30%, but last night the shares were up by 6% on news that they're going to debut a new vehicle at a lower price point. So this is important at the moment because the EV space is being challenged by headwinds, including higher prices for these new EVs. So that was seen as a positive for that organization. Wells Fargo has had a constraint lifted in relation to some regulatory issues that it has faced in recent times, and that saw the shares up by about 7%. Deere International, the marquee brand where tractors are concerned. If you like a nice piece of farming machinery, Deere is your organization to head to. That stock finished down by 6%. The organization posted earnings, but the market a little bit underwhelmed by their outlook. And then on top of that, Albemarle, the lithium miner. So they delivered much better than expected earnings, and that has seen the shares improve by about 2%. So that's worth keeping in mind as far as the atmospherics in the local lithium space is concerned. So their earnings per share are expected to come in at around 80 cents per share. They came in much higher at around $1.85. So a considerable beat there, which can help the shares improve. So as far as the local picture is concerned, it's a pretty busy day as far as company results are concerned. Amongst them, the ASX, IAG, Chicken Farmer, Inghams, and then QBE. So just on that note, QBE has bettered expectations with their earnings this morning. They've been able to charge higher premiums. They're the beneficiaries of rising bond yields as well. So a considerable beat on their earnings, and that should translate to a positive start for that organization. The Aussie dollar has done well again. It has been beaten up earlier on in the week, but it's recovered a lot of the ground that it lost in the last couple of days. It's trading back to around 65.3 US cents. Have a wonderful weekend, and I look forward to speaking to you again on Monday.